So the reason why I painted this painting, or I'm doing this painting, is this theater, the Orpheum, has a lot of history. When I was a kid, I saw this image of these two boys that were on the floor. It's a black and white picture. And when I saw this image, it was very powerful to me. You know, that kid was on the floor, and he looked naked. It looked like they had stripped his clothes. And the other kid looked like he was beat up. And there was a crowd of people around him, around both of the boys, actually. There was a cop there. There was looked like a lady and like a couple, and a bunch of people coming out of the theater, I guess. And that image was very powerful because it looked like these kids had just gotten beaten up and stripped of their clothes. And people were just standing around not doing nothing. And it was kind of sad. And even to this day, every time I see that picture, you know, it's very powerful. I get kind of sad, you know, looking at it, because it happened in 1942, 1943, which was not that long ago. And to have a police officer just standing there over the kids, like, you know, like they were trash, was kind of sad. And history always repeats itself. You know, we're in 2020 now, and I feel some of these images that were taken in the 1940s are appearing again in 2020. And some of this history was in my own backyard, and you don't see it that much. You don't see people talking about it. You know, it's like our little secret, kind of. They don't teach it in school as much. And I believe by me painting this painting here on this theater, because it happened right across the street, you know, it happened in the front of that theater. By me painting that building, and people are gonna ask, oh, why'd you paint this theater, this Orpheum, the Orpheum Theater? It'll reflect back to that story of those kids that, you know, they had no voice. There was nobody there to protect them. Maybe even the cop that's there were protecting them. And even after they got beat up and stripped from their clothes, because they were just wearing these baggy clothes, the wool clothes, and it was like during the war, you know, it was their style. And it was just because they're wearing this fashion that was, you know, part of their culture or whatever. They didn't like that, and they would, you know, they would storm into these cafes, into these restaurants, into these theaters. A bunch of servicemen storming a theater and grabbing you and dragging you out and stripping you of your clothes, and nothing gets done about it. And then you get arrested. You know, that's pretty sad. It happened 70 years ago, but it destroyed a generation of Chicanos trying to be into the military. You know, they after getting beat up and kicked around, you think they're gonna want to join the Navy and all that? Of course not. You know, you think that generation getting arrested by cops and all that, you know, it created this culture of, like, you know, hate the police, you know, hate the servicemen. And it actually created gangs. It made more gangs in LA, because they would gather around in groups to protect themselves from these servicemen and these police. So in reality, it affects people today, because, you know, we have a bunch of gangs now. You know, there's a big gang culture. And it all goes back to some of these events that happened 70 years ago.